Hi, it's Mitch from PickDawgz.com here with your free pick in the Timberwolves versus Jazz NBA matchup on Monday, April 26, 2021. Of course, here on YouTube, I do more free pick videos than anyone, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and check out all of our free pick videos each and every day. Of course, let's get to this free pick video, get to this one between the Timberwolves and the Jazz. The T-Wolves, 17-44 on the season, really one of the worst records in all of the NBA. And while it looks bad on paper, because it is bad, they have the second worst record in the NBA. There's some bright spots here that we've seen, and we've seen some flashes of a team that really not as bad as the record indicates. I know the record is the record, but in today's NBA, players sitting because of injury, and especially a team that's been out of it for quite some time, like the Timberwolves, you don't want to risk your future stars and the future of the franchise, you know, for games that probably aren't all that meaningful. And without the fans in the stands paying the high ticket prices, well, it makes a lot of sense for some of these higher-named players to sit. You know, the Timberwolves, 10-point dogs in this one. They're 4-6 in their last 10 games, so you got to just do some quick math in your head and say they've won 17 games all season, but they've won a quarter of those over the last 10 games. And meanwhile, the Jazz, 44-16, almost inverted, right, the record of the Timberwolves. They've won 6 of their last 10. So a little bit different story there, the way these two teams are playing in comparison to the big picture. Obviously, you'd rather win 6 of your last 10 if you had the choice, as opposed to 4 of your last 10. The Timberwolves' offense is ranked 20th in the NBA. The defense ranked 29th in points allowed, 29th in two-point shooting against, 30th in three-point shooting. This is how you end up with the second worst record in the NBA, while the Utah Jazz, 4th in defense, 2nd in defending the 2, 2nd in defending the 3, and then offensively, the 3rd best in scoring, 3rd best in three-point shooting. This is, you know, it goes on and on. But I think when you look at some of these numbers, and I think it's the same with all the rest of the NBA teams in this season in particular, and I'm not saying it is like this way every single season, but in this season in particular, where players are sitting more than ever and injured players are taking extended leaves more than ever, the stats for the season, I don't think they mean as much. I think they mean a little less, and I think as the teams are playing now has a lot more to do with it. Meanwhile, the Timberwolves got the win against the Jazz just a couple of days ago. This is a back-to-back in Minnesota, the first game was in Utah. Now they play in Minnesota, and back just 2 days ago, the Timberwolves beat the Jazz 101-96 as 12.5-point underdogs. They certainly have that capability, and when you look back at their last 5 games, they've won 3 of their last 5, and 2 of those are against playoff teams, the Heat and the Jazz. The other one was Sacramento Kings, who they played in a back-to-back as well at Sacramento, and they beat them 1, they lost in 1. The other loss was to the Clippers, who, well, a lot of teams have lost to the Clippers this year. And, you know, so not a lot of shame in that, especially for a team that, like I said, has the second worst record in the entire NBA. I don't know. I see the Timberwolves as like I said, not being horrible. I think when they're at semi-full strength, which is where they're at now, they can play with anybody on any given night. I think we saw that last time out against the Jazz. We saw it against the Heat, and we saw it, you know, recently in other games as well. I think that the Timberwolves getting this many points, even with revenge in mind for the Jazz, but the Jazz don't have Donovan Mitchell in the lineup, and that is part of the problem here. I'm not saying that he's a one-man show there in Utah, because he isn't, but he is their best player. I'm going to take the Timberwolves here. I'm going to take the 10 and feel that they at least cover again against the Jazz, and that's going to be my free pick. Of course, if you're wondering who the top handicappers in the world believe are the best bets on the board, just head on over to PickDawgz.com and click on the Premium Picks tab.